We want to determine which of the following statements describe a function. We want to select all the statements that apply. So before we analyze these four statements, let's review what a function is. A function is a relation in which each input has exactly one output. So if we have a function of x, we can say every x value has exactly one y value. Here are two examples of functions. Notice in this first case, every input has exactly one output, or every x value has exactly one corresponding y value. Even in this case, even though these two inputs are sharing the same output, each input does have exactly one output. Notice every x has exactly one y. And here's an example that's not a function. Notice this input has actually two outputs, and therefore it's not a function. It's still a relation, but not a function. So going back to our four statements, the first statement says the amount of revenue a shoe company makes is a function of how many shoes are sold. They make one type of shoe. So if this is a function, the input would be the number of shoes and the output would be the revenue. So we could say f of the number of shoes sold would have to be equal to only one revenue amount. And this is true. For example, if the shoes cost $50 each, if they sell, let's say, 10 pairs of shoes, the revenue would be $500. There's no other amount of revenue possible. And therefore, we can say this situation does describe a function. Next, we have a city's yearly unemployment rate is a function of the year. So again, if this is a function, the input would be the year, and the output would be the unemployment rate. So we would have f of the year would be equal to the unemployment rate. So for example, if we select 1 year, there's only going to be one yearly unemployment rate, and therefore this does represent a function. There's no way that 1 year could have two yearly unemployment rates. So once again, this does describe a function. Next, we have the number of miles traveled is a function of the average rate of travel. So in this case, the input would be the average rate of travel, and the output would be the number of miles traveled. So we can say f of the rate would have to be equal to the number of miles traveled. So for example, if you're traveling 60 miles an hour for, let's say, 3 hours, then the output or the number of miles would be 180 miles. It could not be some other distance traveled with the same average rate of travel. And therefore, every average rate does only have one amount of miles traveled. So once again, this is a function. The last statement, a person's income is a function of their height. So here, the input would be the height, and the output would be the income. So if this is a function, we would have f of the height is equal to the income amount. So for example, if someone is 6 feet tall, is it possible to only have one possible income? And of course that's false. If someone is 6 feet tall, there's a bunch of people that are 6 feet tall. They will not always make the same amount of income. There'll be many incomes of people with the same height. And therefore, this would not represent a function. But the first three still do. I hope you found this explanation helpful.